INFPs are not brainless. INFPs are sophisticated people who, on the outside, may seem strange, but on the inside have so much creative power. They have an innate ability to come up with ideas and show remarkable understanding in such a manner that no one else could. It is wise to conclude that INFPs have no limitation in creativity. This explains why they are successful in their chosen career, such as music and literature. Those who become psychologists show unparalleled intuition that places them on the higher rung of success. Musical composers have an innate capacity to grasp lyrics and tunes with unequal prowess. This explains the fact that the minds of the INFPs are like a deep well, filled with rainbow-colored water that splashes with bursts of ingenuity and creativity at each thought. Different ways people perceive the INFPs. The INFPs are distinguished by their whimsical intelligence, based on intuition and intelligence. Most of the population does not possess this ingenious characteristic. Only about 14% of the population possess intuitive, N, plus feeling, F, which translates to the visionary. The people who misclassify the INFPs believe they are silly or incompetent. The reason for this is not far-fetched. This class of people is most drawn to sensual interpretation. They're geared towards sensing and thinking rather than intuition and feelings. This implies that they make decisions based on concrete details, logic, or fact about issues. This class of people believe the INFPs are illogical and have their heads in the clouds. They lack a basic understanding of the peculiar and creative nature of the INFPs. The misunderstanding of the INFPs is understandable because they go through life in a slightly dreamlike state where everything appears and feels not so real. Truth be told, the INFPs could be in touch with reality, but most of the time, life feels like a story or a dream. Therefore, most of them seem unfocused with things that don't seem to go down well with them, especially for the sensing and thinking types of personalities. On the bright side, the INFPs are so good at writing. Writing comes naturally to them, just like dreaming with open eyes. The INFPs are extremely good because life itself appears to them a dream reality. Those who believe the INFPs are brainless. Those who think this way do not entirely comprehend who the INFPs are. Most times, when they see the INFPs struggle to hold logical arguments, they assume these creative people are lacking in intellectual capacity. This denies the truth. The INFPs are people with remarkable intelligence, yet a different intelligence because they could make up complex stories or understand the reason behind certain behaviors of people around them in the shortest possible time. The intuitive and creative skills of the INFPs are not obvious to those around them. The INFPs are a powerful and well-developed set of people who are capable of many things, from writing amazing books to gaining psychological insights into the minds of people around them. That they daydream sometimes and lack the focus to pay attention to real-world issues or cannot follow a particular routine doesn't make them brainless, incompetent, or stupid. Despite many people seeing the INFPs as brainless, many other people see them in a different light, such as childlike. For example, it is now a piece of public knowledge in the MBTI online community that the INFPs are the children of the MBTI, who possess the innate trait of being idealistic to almost an unrealistic level. For instance, the INFPs could come up with make-believe games to make the day come alive interestingly, such as pretending a car behind the car they drive is chasing them. In another instance, they could imagine a world where no animal is killed or where everyone is a vegetarian. When people see them imagine or do things in this manner, they are often put off by these views and actions. These natural character phenomena make their unique charm. If you find yourself put off by the very natural nature of the INFPs, you may well seek a new company. Spending time with people who look down on them or those who do not buy into the natural personalities of the INFPs is unhealthy. The INFPs are childlike, and it is this nature that sustains their remarkable creative power and ingenuity. A childlike mindset of the INFPs is the fountain from which their creativity flows and allows them to play around the ingenuity of new and interesting ideas. The unrealistic ideals, or the true idealism of the INFPs, are highly essential for the creativity of the group, without which they are becoming little champions who use their talents and skills to help other people in life may be impossible. Besides, without believing in a world better than the one they live in, mustering the courage and strength to help other people or improve the environment they live in would be difficult. Those who believe the INFPs are important. Notwithstanding the people who believe less in the INFPs, many view them as important as any other persons. These people are also called the NFs, or the visionaries, and they include the INFJs, ENFPs, or the ENFJs. Another group of people who share similar views are like-minded creative people who understand the unique nature and brand of intelligence of the INFPs. For example, I was conversing with the director of an architecture firm for an interview over his role in the company, and he complimented my brand of intelligence. He was amazed at my level of ingenuity, strengths, and creativity. This level of amazement is common among people who expressed surprises over the level of insights and ideas the INFPs possess. Each time they come in contact with the INFPs, especially where their ingenious creativity is at play, their respect for the INFPs suddenly skyrockets. In my personal experience in high school, the level of respect and admiration people accord me increased when I excelled at English in high school and got the prestigious award. The sudden nice and gentle treatment I received was overwhelming, simply because I proved to them I was not the much talked about daydreamer, but a smart and intelligent fellow. Those who believe INFPs are mad. Some people believe the INFPs are mad, and there is no doubt they could be mad, in a manner of speaking. The creativity of the INFPs distinguishes them simply because of their ability to make connections between different things, objects, and ideas, and combine them into new ideas and concepts highly ingeniously. But this ability could come out as crazy for some people. For instance, I recently had a conversation with my sister about supervillains. It's intriguing that while she was being logical discussing the traits of the supervillains, my mind had already wondered about how I would use the supervillain traits in my novel. The devilish nature and image of the evil creatures were so frightening that it showed on my face. And when I explained to her why I was so shocked, she simply called me weird, though I was simply exercising my creative power. How INFPs see the world. There are different ways people perceive INFPs, but how did the INFPs perceive the world around them? The truth remains that they see the world from their creative perspectives. They seem to dislike reality because it holds no magic for them, such types that involve pixies, spells, and wands. The INFPs would be happier if everyone would use magical things in a world where flying pets to transport their groceries and where ATMs spat out fortune rather than money. They love everything weird and whimsical. So sad, the reality is often the same, unchanging and governed by its set of rules. Nature is still the same. So far, cats are still incapable of human speech and cannot fly. So the INFPs see things differently and deal with reality by turning almost everything magical, fun, or whimsical within their heads. For instance, we might pretend that life is more of a simulation or game where you have to work to collect things. And in such a world, we believe that working increases society points in the game, while visiting increases social points. In this game-like world, going about your everyday business makes life fun. or when you pay money for something, you would imagine it's not a kind of currency, but a unit representing effort, value, time, etc. Thus, anytime you buy something, you are paying with the soul currency, and you could find something like a plantation where people have wisps of their souls extracted to create a currency for society. In this way, those whose souls are kind and well worth more than those whose souls are otherwise. The above scenario summarizes the INFPs are a creative set of people who believe that chimneys are not chimneys, but a gateway to homes in the other worlds. Simply put, that if it's nifty, whimsical, or lovely, the INFPs love it. On the outside, the INFPs may appear as blank cardboard and like an average person, but the sophisticated and advanced INFPs can blend with a society or crowd and could smoothly present themselves as even more logical and mature than others. Yet, this takes nothing from who they are really on the inside. The minds of the INFPs are beautifully and wonderfully different, though no one understands this. Even if people misunderstand them and find them strange or childish, simply get along with them and find them an interesting part of being with them. No matter how you view them, they are smart and ingenious people, though they have their inner worlds, full of magic, beauty, wonder, and surreal things. See them as an essential part of our world, without which things may appear incomplete. See their creativity as gifts to humanity. No wonder most of the greatest artists, writers, musicians of this generation are INFPs. They are uniquely different, and that's what makes them who they are and keeps the world going round.